Now let's toast to the hustlers.
Welcome back once again. We're back at the Tartt Entertainment Show. You got your host, your co-host JK, and also Tartt. And we're gonna go ahead and jump off into what's been going on. Now, we told you last show we're gonna talk about somebody in the political arena.
And Alvin Greene.
AKA Al Green for short. Now, for those, like I said, that don't know about Alvin Greene.
We wearing the green shirts.
For yeah, him. Exactly.
He got on the green. I'm wearing the green.
For those of y'all that don't know, in the state of South Carolina.
The most you had state.
It's debatable, but I won't dispute this show.
One of. Keep it moving.
In the state of South Carolina, you had a Democratic runoff. And in that Democratic runoff, I don't know how many people that was running for, but people were running and voted, what? raised thousands, millions of dollars to try to get the Senate, win the Senate race to run against the Republican Party in November. So this took place about a month ago.
The primaries took place.
Now in South Carolina, you had a couple of people on the ballot. One of those people happened to be
Al Green.
All right.
Now, Alvin Green.
And running for the Democratic primary. Now, Alvin Green, let's give a little background information on him.
U.S. Army, U.S. Air Force, graduate of South Carolina, unemployed, majored in political science.
And what else? He's banned from the campus of South Carolina.
He's banned from the campus of the University of South Carolina because he went to a young woman and said, "Do you like football?"
Yes, of course.
And in this process of him saying that, he produced objects or pictures of pornography to this young woman and also said, "I'm trying to get my thoughts straight. Let's go back to your room." Okay, he's being charged with that. That's still under investigation. We're not going to get too deep in that. But how can a guy like that?
Wait. They held the election of the primary.
They held this election
against all these people who spent their lives in politics and everything, and then got nobody ever heard of.
Unemployed guy who runs no campaign whatsoever, no signs, no website, no shirts.
Who wins the primary?
Alvin Green wins 60% of the vote.
All right, Alvin Green won.
Where does this come from, man? This dude wins 100,362 votes. He ran against Vic Rawls, incumbent, who only received 69,553 votes. A nobody. JK, you telling me if I ran for an office here in Alabama, no signs, no nothing, could I get 60% of the votes? Let's be truthful. No campaign, no sign, nothing. Unemployed. I got a charge on me, obscenity charge for like a lewd and lascivious act.
But nobody knows about that.
That's under investigation, but you get 60% of the vote? Get out of here.
You got a hot
dude.
Well, this is the thing. These are the theories.
Give me one of them.
Either
I want one.
Either people they have the alphabetical theory, which is that A is the first letter of the alphabet, so people voted for A.
Or they actually
thought
he was the singer Al.
Personal opinion is that, and you know, Democratic primary, if you did have some black people vote, some black people did vote for him. But also, you had a lot of white people vote too. But a lot of people looked at the name and voted on the name and said, Alvin Green. Al Green. It can't be that bad. Al Green. I'm going to vote Al Green. Instead of just saying, I don't know anything about this guy. I'm not going to vote on this thing.
This election disgusts me, man, because this dude And I researched a lot of this. I saw a lot of the interviews, and this dude was just a plain out joke.
Did any of y'all see the interviews of Alvin Greene? Please, if you haven't, go to YouTube and pull up Alvin Greene with an E at the end. G-R-E-E-N-E.
This dude is unemployed. How does he get $10,000?
Well, he said he was military, so he probably saved his military disability.
But you're talking about a guy, okay, he saved his military checks in this, but when he's got a charge against him for obscenities, he takes a public defender. Shouldn't you put your money towards a lawyer so you can beat your case?
He saved all his money. His money was spent on the $10,000.
Man, this guy's a shill. I'm not a police shield, a shill. S-H-I-L-L, a shill. And a shill is a person who is paid to help another person or an organization to sell goods or a service. And that's illegal. It's illegal. I had enough of this guy. This guy is comical. Do not vote for him, man. This dude has no basis. He's talking about, we're going to put South Carolina back to work. You don't even have a job yourself.
And you're in South Carolina. Who do you vote for? Do you vote for Alvin Greene, this unknown person? Or do you vote for the Republican who's already stated out and out that he's against the Obama agenda?
The agenda.
So who are you voting for?
I'm going to say this, man. If I'm in South Carolina, I don't vote at all. I don't even go out to the polls. I refuse to vote. This guy is a disgrace to the human race. Just watch the interviews. This is like a college graduate.
He graduated?
He graduated from South Carolina. I'm sorry, I threw my notes everywhere. Yeah. He graduated from college, man. I just don't see this guy in Senate. Like, what is he going to bring to the table? What does this guy bring to the table? He barely brought $10,000 to get his name on the ballot. No, this guy's a joke.
He's bringing in them votes, though. I know that.
He's bringing in votes because he's a Republican plant.
I'll tell you what. You got you a good name out there, people? Go ahead and put your name on a ballot. Take
man.
A chance. Let's get off of him.
Let's get on your boy.
No. Let's get off of him.
He's going to get off of him.
And let's get on the voters of South Carolina because they're the ones that voted for him. Who are you really mad at? I'm mad at the voters of South Carolina for saying, Alvin Greene, Al Green, I like the name. I'm going to vote for him.
And
not knowing the issues.
Maybe so.
I'm mad at the voters of South Carolina.
I'm mad at everybody in South Carolina because it shows the caliber of people, though.
Are you serious? In today's age, the information age, a person that ran no campaign, did not go door to door, and held one public meeting.
He said he did. He said he did in his 03 vehicle. He said he went. He drives an 03 vehicle.
I gotta get me one of them.
The 03 is an inside joke. Watch the videos and you'll understand that. It's a joke.
Yeah, I agree.
He's making a mockery of the election system. Man, this dude, no, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
He didn't make a mockery of the election
system. The voters did too.
The voters of South Carolina made a mockery of themselves.
He just made a mockery of himself doing those interviews with my man Don Lemon.
What y'all should do now is look at the issues. Look at what he says. Look at what his opponent says.
Man, dude,
don't just write him off now.
He can't even talk in a full sentence.
You're right. Oh, that.
You talk about look at some issues. He can't even. Man.
What's the question they were asking him?
Yes. You got one word answers. Are you up for the job?
Yes.
Can you handle this?
Yes.
Is it time to end this Tartt Entertainment show about Alvin Greene?
Yes.
We go end it like that tonight, man. I'm sorry, man.
Quote unquote of Alvin Greene, right?
Man,
there.
It was just a little animated tonight, but man, I'm real deep about that subject, man. I don't even want to go through
1992.
We ain't even gonna go through Manning,
Greene,
South Carolina.
Reunion. He had a campaign shirt. He had a family reunion shirt on.
Man, it's your boy J.
Stop being honest, man. It's over. Y'all, yeah, I think lower, y'all, man.
He's JK. Michael Tartt, man. It's the Tartt Entertainment Show.
Do vote.
Please vote. We stress that. Just vote.